The revolution will be live.
Back to the lead. My political panel is with me. Symone, the White House says that the president is open, at least, to changes in background checks. Now, that's quite a wide area. It depends on, it's all going to be in the details here. This apparently the result of a conversation with his sons and Geraldo Rivera over the weekend at Mar-a-Lago. Do you see a president here who might be moved by the tragedy we saw in Parkland to break with his party?
Again, Donald Trump was more, in my opinion, upset about the Mueller investigation than the young people who lost their lives last week. So, look, I think if the president can help be behind something that results in gun control, some actual codified legislation, mm-hmm. then I'm all here for it. But we need to know specifically what he is here for. And his track record is that he's all over the place on some things. So when we were talking about immigration and the Dreamers, whether it was about the tax bill, Donald Trump needs to be very specific, and his administration needs to be very specific about what they will back, what they'd like to see. But again, I think it's on these young people who are pushing the institutions to make the changes that we really want to see.
Paris, what do you believe would be an acceptable change? I mean, often the rote response to this is no single gun law can prevent any shooting, and therefore let's stop the discussion of any changes to gun laws. But do you see an openness not only from the president but from other Republicans to changes?
Absolutely, and I think you're right. No single gun law will deter that, because if you put all the guns control legislation that you want to, but if you have the desire to do something, to really carry out something, you're going to do it. And I think the thing that I like about the president and how he's approaching this is the fact that the president and the administration did put out something very specific, and that's the Republican-backed Senate bill from Senator Cornyn out of Texas, that they said the president is open to open to that piece of legislation. The president is also, I give him credit for having a listening session with some of the survivors from the Parkland shooting. That is showing the president is willing to listen. And people have said that, and I don't know if it's true, that he was walking around talking and asking people for their, getting a pulse on how they felt about gun control and what the federal response should do. But let's be clear, this is not one thing that the president himself can do alone. It's going to have to take the entire Congress to also act, which they failed to do well before President Trump came in office, but while President Obama was in office as well. So this is something that is going to have to be bipartisan, but I appreciate the fact that the president is at least open and is signaling where he wants to be open, and that's the Cornyn piece of legislation.
The voices, Bill Kristol, that we've heard from students, survivors of this, classmates, the 17 who were killed, or students of some of the teachers who were killed, have been particularly powerful this time. Have a listen to one of them speaking about this.
We don't have to encourage them to get those guns. We can make it harder, absolutely make it harder, and we can prevent some seriously nasty crimes and some seriously indescribable tragedies from occurring.
Every answer is a solution at this point, because we haven't tried any of them.
This kid was reported to police dozens of times. There were warnings, etc., and yet he was able to buy 10 weapons. Will Republican lawmakers be open to making it harder to get weapons like that, particularly assault weapons like the AR-15?
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, I think it's possible this time. I think both in terms of making it harder to get them and also lessening their killing power in various ways. And I'm not a gun person, so I don't understand all this. But there were things. Remember after Vegas, there was an agreement for about 48 hours on the bump stocks. And then what happened?
Well, you know what happened? It got punted. There were a couple of Republican lawmakers. I've known because I follow this every week to see where it went. It got punted to ATF, which is now in a year-long process. It's called sort of a review. They've gone out for comments to see if they might change the rules. But in terms of a legislative fix, that went nowhere.
But, I mean, the killing power of some of these weapons mm-hmm. could be reduced just with some technical, making it harder. I mean, you never can make anything impossible to make them as effective killing machines.
You made the point, which is a frequent Republican point, that people will still kill if they want to. What's wrong with making it harder?
There's nothing wrong with making it harder for those who are mentally unstable to get weapons.
Why did the Republican Congress pass a law and the president signed it to make it easier for people with mental health issues?
Well, you got to ask the Congress, you got to ask the president. But I will tell you that when you look at Chicago from Martin Luther King Day to the incident that happened in Parkland, there were 17 murders from gun violence and over 80 that were victims.
I know Chicago's a favorite talking.
No, it's not a favorite talking.
All I want to say is,
my point is,
had the Parkland shooter been black or brown, we wouldn't be talking about the types of legislation we could and could not make happen. Because because if he was yelling Allah Akbar, Congress and the president, one would have been tweeting about it, and they would have swooped in and did whatever
That's
they felt
true.
Needed.
They didn't change the gun laws after Islamic
that,
violence. Did they change the gun laws
I
after San Bernardino?
We know we have a Muslim ban. Damn it, there's a whole Muslim ban.
Did we change the gun laws after San Bernardino?
What I am saying is this.
You know, you don't have to demagogue this.
No, I'm not demagoguing anything. But what I am saying,
you don't have to make it about race.
Okay, be clear. I want to be really clear. White supremacists have repeatedly slipped through the fingers of the FBI. Repeatedly. This is a pattern. What about...
And you think the FBI doesn't care about white
killers? I'm not saying the FBI does not care, but what I am saying is there is a pattern, and we cannot ignore a pattern in this country. So if self-identified white supremacists, this young man trained with a white supremacist paramilitary in Florida. Had he been training, had these been black or brown people that had been training with a paramilitary in Florida, the FBI would have done something about it.
Listen, this is the reason, thank you for your passion, because it's a passionate issue for anybody who's watching this as an American. I know you share that as well, Paris and Bill. This is the reason we're going to have this town hall on Wednesday to talk about this deeper, and it's certainly a conversation we're going to do our best to keep up here on CNN. Thanks very much to Symone, Paris, and to Bill Kristol.
The revolution will be live.